Welcome to another episode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean the Fogcrawler. Today we're in Hydesville, California. We're having ourselves a pizza competition. We're going to be doing two artisan pizzas in the Dutch oven, and we're also competing against a wood-fired brick pizza oven. I'm going to show you how versatile these Dutch ovens really are. Talking about making pizzas in a Dutch oven, there's been a lot of discussion in the forum about the perfect setup for doing a pizza. First one that came up is take a lid inverter, put a lid on it, build yourself a ring, and use another lid on top. The objective is to get the lid closer to the pizza so that it bakes better. A friend of mine even made his own pizza oven. What it basically is an upside down Dutch oven. It works well too. But what works best for me is just your standard camp style Dutch oven. First thing you want to do is you want to dust your pastry board. This will keep the pizza dough from sticking. Once you have your dough ball down there, take and you dust the top. And then you just want to roll the dough out. Just want to get it pushed out enough so that you can nice uniform skin. You want to trim your skin so that you have a uniform sized pizza dough, and you really want to click on the description below the video to take a look at the recipe for this dough. You got to make this dough the day before you plan on making your pizza. Start of one pizza skin. Once you got your skin trimmed, you want to take, sprinkle on some coarse cornmeal. This is going to impart a crunchy corn flavor, something that they use in the hearth type style ovens, and it's really good. Is we want to dock the dough. This is going to keep air bubbles from popping up when you're baking it. If you don't have a dough docker like this, you can use just a regular kitchen fork. Okay, after you dock it, put a piece of parchment paper down. This is going to end up being the bottom of the dough. And you just flip it over.
Amazing.
Peel up your pastry board. And I think I'm going to transfer it over to this bigger peel. And you can redock it. Now it's ready to go into the oven. This is the only reason why I use parchment paper when I'm doing a pizza in the Dutch oven. It's to get the dough in the oven. Watch how difficult this is. Whoa, that's easy. Now what I want to do is I want to get just a little bit of a lip up the sidewall of the oven. And that's going to give my dough like a little reservoir for extra stuff. Now we put the sauce on. If I would have brought olive oil with me, I would have brushed some olive oil around the edge. That helps give it a better crust, crisper crust, I should say. Now we just want to take and push the sauce out. Okay, you want to put about a pound of shredded mozzarella down, and then we put the bacon on. Get it spread out. And at this point, it's ready to go into the oven. The rest of the ingredients get put on after it's cooked. We've got a ring of 20 coals on the bottom. I've got about 45 on top. We're gonna let this go around 20 minutes and we'll check it. All right, the pizza's been in the oven for about 20 minutes. Let's take a peek and see how she looks. Ooh, that's looking good, I'd say. Okay, we're gonna let this sit for a few minutes to let the cheese take a set. And then we're gonna put some mayonnaise on top. Yep, that's right, mayonnaise. And the mayonnaise does two things. It enhances the flavor a little bit, but more importantly, it's gonna be a binder to keep the chilled vegetables on top after we get it sliced up. People from the East Coast, they don't understand the mayonnaise on the pizza thing. But it's a widely used practice out here in the West. Okay, the next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna pre-slice it before we put the chilled vegetables on top.
Yeah, we learned that one hard way.
We had vegetables going everywhere. Boy, listen to that cornmeal crunch. I love it.
Don't break tradition, huh?
Put the lettuce first. Back!
Just in time for BLT pizza, Mitchell!
I was just inside taking a break from staring outside with you guys for a while.
I don't blame you, we're pretty full too.
That looks good.
Mm-hmm. I was playing on my computer.
And there you have it. The BLT Artisan Pizza. And here's our double feature for the day. We're going to be doing a Frontiersman. This is an all-meat pizza, and the sauce is mostly barbecue sauce. All right, we've got about a pound of mozzarella down. Now we're going to put the bacon on. We're going to spread that around. Next, we're going to put on Canadian bacon. Then we're going to work the pepperoni in between.
Yeah.
And now we gotta do a little stitching with some cheese, so when we start putting additional layers, it kind of holds everything together once everything's hot, cooked, and melted. Now we got these tasty little salami nuggets, my favorite.
Is there a meat you don't like, Dean?
Liver? No, I like liver. Now we put some linguica on, and linguica look lovely.
Has this linguica been cooked?
Yes.
All right, so yes. Meats are...
All the meats have been cooked. And we need some Polish sausage.
I hope the tailgate will hold it all.
It will. So we get the Polish down. And now we gotta put a little more cheese to hold everything together. Okay, we got the cheese put on there to hold everything together. Now we put the crumbled sausage down. Just gonna add a little bit of cheese to hold that on. Throw some cheddar in there for color. And final ingredient is a little bit Italian seasoning. And that is a frontiersman ready to bake.
Okay, setting it up on the table now, and you're going to cook it hot and fast.
20 underneath, 45 to 50 on top.
What size oven?
14 inch, a little bit, right around 20 minutes. Probably a little bit more because we had so many ingredients.
Nah, there's not too much meat on that pizza.
Nah, never have enough meat. All right, the Frontiersman has been cooking for about 20, 25 minutes, somewhere in that neighborhood. Let's take a look. Oh, that looks good. I think it's ready. Ooh, yeah. Doesn't that look tasty? We'll let this sit a second, and then we'll slice it up.
Okay, here we have the Frontiersman pizza. I can see those seasonings on the top.
Lost our little lip right there.
All right, for those of us that like a little bit of meat on our pizza, this is your pizza.
That is a meat pizza.
I'll wait.
It really is mine now.
Kevin gave us a wedding gift, which is...
a George Boyette Camp Pizza Oven.
Okay, made in America. 14 inch. Custom made. Thanks, Kev.
Well, I hope you enjoyed today's webisode. That was some mighty fine pizza. I'm Dean the Fogcrawler. Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors.
I'm Joni the Teardrop Nutty. Thanks for joining us today with the Fortuna Dutch Oven Society featuring pizzas. Happy trails to you until the next time.
My new wife.
For life.
Okay.